like you to sit in the synapse for what I'm going to say next. It is not to figure out, but just to my question many years ago continues to be, but what happens when more information comes in than we can process? I'm not asking that as an answer. That was just a self-question, and looking at the nervous system, one of the things I found in myself and with others was what, remember to keep just feeling the information coming in the back and out the front. That's your job right now. Not to do what I say, okay? You're gonna listen to what I say, but just keep coming in the front and the back and out the front. Is that clear?
But that's not sitting in the synapse. Because it's coming out.
Well, that's the cycle of it. It's coming, just let it keep coming in, and then let it go. Okay, thank you. Let the cycle be. It comes in, goes where it wants to go, but that you're going to go out the front if you're going to go anywhere. Thank you for clarifying that. What I feel happens when more information comes in than we can process, in order to save our lives so we don't die of shock, too much nervous system, I don't mean die of shock, but in order to deal with something that comes in that we can't handle, we refuse the information into the posterior horn. And we say, go back, I can't process this now, I need more time. And so it goes back into the tissues and says, tissues, hold this pattern until it can be processed. And little by little, when we sit in the synapse, we can take little by little that information in and process it, either into a motor act, into an emotional understanding or expression, or intellectual awareness, that our heart, we will see next week, can absorb it. And this theory, or this experiential theory, came about 30 years ago, and maybe 20 years ago or something, I don't remember, I'm not a good counter. Somebody found in the literature, I think it was around 86, that there was some support that there could be a reversal in the posterior nerve pathway. And rather, the scientists had found it or not, I think it was a sheep or something, that it's really important to not force information in that you can't receive. To accept all the things in our history that we have not been able to absorb, and to little by little allow information in that we don't have to do anything about except to accept and to sit with it and to choose the easy path. Because as information comes in that caused great tension or great whatever, if we get into the membrane, we can re-experience it in a way that doesn't actually help us come through it. We just reenact it. But if we find the easy path, just go under the tone and say, this bit, I accept. But don't force anything in that causes more stress than you can process through sitting in the synapse. Now, this is a large group, so always be aware of how much support you can receive. Because usually when something, we carry something that has caused us pain or discomfort or whatever we want to call it, distress, we haven't had the support we needed to process it. So if it's an individual session, a private session, there's more support available than there is in a group. But the group can support in a different way than an individual. I one of the people who helped me understand this was a man who had a chronic back problem, a very successful businessman in New York. And he said, the phone can just ring and my back hurts. I said, what would happen if you didn't answer it? I never thought of that. He didn't answer the phone. I said, just sit in the synapse. Just sit with it. Let the hear the phone ring. And you don't have to do anything but hear it ring. And that was the key to healing his back. Because he began to feel it in the rest of his life. So we're not inhibiting. In a way we're inhibiting, but it's not like, stop, I'm not going to answer the phone. That's a motor act. It's just, hear the phone ring. You don't have to turn the ringer off. Just accept that the phone is ringing. And where you can, let the information in the back and out the front. And when you need to reject it in the back, accept that that's too much. And it's okay. And then we come back earlier to the embryology and we can go, no. We can have a motor act, external, rather than internal, and no to ourselves. We can say a no to maybe what it is in ourselves or at the outer world. Or we can disconnect the phone. Because it came through the pathway of in the back and out the front, instead of in the back, no, I'm going to go out the back. In the back.